Hey, moms and dads, who among us hasn't been at one time or other asked that embarrassing age-old childhood question, Mommy, Daddy, where do toy soldiers come from? Well, my name's Mannie Gentile. Welcome to Toy Soldiers Forever. We're going to answer that question in this episode. Oh yeah, the sun is shining, the birds are chirping, it's beautiful outside. Welcome to spring in Washington County, Maryland, everyone. I'm Mannie Gentile, and welcome to the backyard of Toy Soldiers Forever. On this segment, we're going to learn how to homecast pewter toy soldiers. Now, you really have to prepare your surface. Of course, everything in this process needs to be burn-proof, especially your fingers. So I'm using these ceramic tiles as a way of sandwiching my molds together, to keep them nicely pressed together tightly so there's no leaks. You'll know you've got a leak if you just keep pouring pewter in and it keeps going in and in and in and in and in and ends up dripping out down on the floor or something. That's why I like to do this outdoors. I like to have prepared surfaces that aren't going to scorch if molten pewter hits them. Now I make a sandwich, my mold's in the middle, my ceramic tile on the outside. Then I take my handy dandy dollar store clamps. These cost a buck a piece. And I clamp the whole thing together. And this is just enough pressure to make it happen, because what you want is for the pewter to be able to go in, but for the air in the mold to be able to escape out between the two halves. Any more pressure than this and those that air won't be able to get out. So now we're actually ready to pour. Let me get my gloves on. Safety first. Now for casting my toy soldiers, I use pewter. Don't use tin, I don't use lead, just pewter. It has a low melting point and it's non-toxic. Now if you're wondering where can I get pewter, oh, there are casting companies that will be happy to sell it to you. And the thing about pewter is, it's really expensive, all right? So here's my recommendation to you. Do what I do. Cruise garage sales, dollar stores, bargain basements. Look for anything made of pewter. Belt buckles, beer mugs. There's all kinds of really bad, poor taste stuff out there made of pewter. You don't care what it looks like. You just throw it in the pot and melt it down. I had an old friend back in Michigan, God bless him, Carl Ulanowitz. He once came up to me with his big, gaudy pewter belt buckle. U.S. Navy with a big anchor. And he said, hey, I picked this up for you at a garage sale. Knowing you're an old Navy man, I thought you'd really like it. And you know what? He was right. Oh, and here's a tip. Don't get hornswoggled by someone who says you can use linotype lead for your toy soldier casting. This stuff is toxic, has a real high melting temperature. Once you get it poured into those molds are going to start to burn immediately. Stay away from lead of all sorts, okay? Thanks. Now here's how you test the temperature of your pewter. You just take a light strip of cardboard, this is just from a vanilla wafers box, and you put the end of it into the melting pot, right into the molten pewter. Now if it bursts into flames, that means it's way too hot. What you want to do is just have that pewter hot enough so that the paper smolders. Okay, let's open a couple of these up and see what we've got. Now, usually the first couple pours that you do, the cavities won't fill all the way. And that's because the molds are still cold. They got to really warm up. That is, the rubber molds have to get pretty hot before that pewter starts evenly distributing itself. Let's open the first one. Okay, we got an officer on horseback. You see, the only thing that didn't come out on him was his sword. His sword didn't completely connect in this little channel right here. So he ignominiously goes back in the pot. That's what I like about this hobby. There is no wasted material. Let's pull this guy out. This is our shouting guy. Let's take a look at him. He's okay, but he's not perfect. So into the pot he goes. And our third guy is some kind of advancing officer, and he appears to be all there. Okay, here's a separate arm which you attach with super glue or epoxy, but some of the details a little indistinct, so he goes back into the melting pot too. Okay, let's start breaking out some molds here. Clamps off. Take my sandwich apart. Check my figure. Advancing flag guy. Pretty good detail, pretty good relief. He is, the base is a little small, but he's a keeper. Mold back together. Back in the sandwich. Second guy, shouting guy, nope. Bad definition. Back into the pot with him. And back together, back in the sandwich. Third mold is our horseman again. I think this is the last time I'll do this guy. But very good definition. We've got a complete sword here. He's looking good. Looks a little like my brother-in-law, Mark Moran. That's kind of interesting. All right, slap this baby back together. Mark is a piano player, by the way, in Grand Rapids, Michigan. If you need high-quality salon entertainment, Mark Moran, the people's man, is the man to go to. That was high-capacity cavity right there. Took a lot of pewter. If you smell rubber burning, your pewter's too hot. And frankly, I think I've been running my pewter a little hot today. And that is not good for the life of your molds. Where do you get these molds, by the way? A couple places. You can always buy commercial molds. And a great place I find my molds, like everyone else and everything else, eBay. Just, go to the toys and collectibles or whatever, type in casting molds or toy soldier molds, and you should be all set. Another thing you can do, if you're a handy guy like me, you can buy high temperature silicone and make your own molds. I made plastic prototypes of little soldiers. From that, I made these high temperature Dow Corning silicone molds. They take very high temperature. And then I just cast the pewter into them. Now, those figures are unlike any others. That is to say, they are unique to Mannie Gentile and Toy Soldiers Forever. You can see them on my blog, as a matter of fact. And back before I got my handy-dandy space-age Lee casting pot, which is really great and really speeds up the process and is quite safe, before that, I was using my good old Civil War-era shot ladle, heating up the pewter over a Coleman stove, then pouring it into my molds. Now this works just fine, don't get me wrong, but between the fumes that were coming off the molten metal and the Coleman fumes, I would spend about half a day just trying to detoxify, if you get my drift. So I'd go with one of these and stay away from one of these. And above all, my friends, be safe. And there we go. Our hour of pleasant afternoon casting has gotten us nearly two dozen little toy soldiers. Outstanding. Okay, that'll be it for today. Next time we get together, we're going to prime and paint these little guys, make them look really cool. So until then, watch your temperature and soldier on.